from the crowd means having the confidence in embracing who you are as a person and accepting your individuality. What makes us unique and different from the next person is something to cherish. Whether it's your talents or your hair color, personal things about us are special. But what if every day you were attacked for being different, instantly becoming a constant target for taunting, ridicule, and hate? For some, this is what life is like on a day-to-day basis, in the classroom, the playground, and even for adults in the workplace. When we think back to our childhood, we might remember that one kid that always ended up being the brunt of a mean joke or got pushed and picked on simply by existing. They were maybe small in stature or just carried themselves different than most. Weak from the outside in, they just couldn't catch a break. Unable to stand up for themselves, they were easy targets. I know what it's like firsthand about bullying. As a young girl, torment on my younger siblings was constant, and picking on them was considered fun. I've even done it to my peers and those I called friend. I didn't realize the impact bullying had until roles were reversed and I became the bully. Being non-popular and soft-spoken were only few personal traits that made it easy for me to be picked on. After days of feeling low and less of myself, I realized just how serious bullying can be. In order to help you understand bullying and its impact, I will share with you what it is and the effects of bullying, its forms, and ways to prevent it. Before I give you a complete insight on bullying, let's go into what bullying is and the effects it can have. Bullying is very common in society. Bullying is a form of unwanted aggressive behavior that can sometimes be violent. A bully will often do mean or hurtful things to anyone who might seem weak socially or have different ways of defending themselves or defending themselves at all. It also involves an imbalance of power with physical strength, access to embarrassing information, and popularity to control that person. When bullies use this power, it often has damaging effects on a person. Suicide and even murder are ways victims try to overcome or seek freedom from the hurt and pain of a bully. School shootings and acts of domestic terrorism are all due to some form of bullying. According to Kay Robinson in her article, Bullying Fact Sheet, imbalance of power or strength leads to long-term negative consequences for both bullies and victims. Bullies are more likely to drop out of school or engage in criminal behavior. Victims can suffer from extreme anxiety, low self-esteem, and depression. Now that you know what bullying is and its effects, I will talk about the differences on the types of bullying and one can experience. Physical attributes, gender, and sexuality are different reasons kids bully. Even race can allow you to be singled out. Different types of bullying can be verbal, social, and physical. Verbal bullying is saying mean things or teasing. Social bullying can affect another's reputation, like spreading rumors, and physical bullying involves hurting another's body or possessions. According to Hogan Shiro's blog, bullying is in fact widespread and not restricted to American society, but instead found across the globe. He also states that bullying is harmful and used to injure others physically, emotionally, or socially. Now that we have covered the types of bullying, I want to talk about ways we can prevent bullying from happening. What can we do as family, teachers, and friends of those who've been bullied? One way to stop bullying is to stop it where it starts. Addressing this problem can convey that bullying behavior should never be tolerated. Enforcing consequences on bullying can contribute to its prevention. It allows the individual to understand just how serious acts of bullying can be, and it's wrong and only leads to more problems. If we educate on bullying and enforce bullying policies, more people will be against this type of cruelty and be encouraged to step in. According to Jonathan Fass in his book, many dedicated anti-bullying programs are currently available from faith-based programs, educational consultants, nonprofits, and even the federal government. Names Day is an event in many schools across the country made by students that provide an opportunity for adults and teens to reshape a school into a civil community. Now that you are aware of bullying and all of its concepts, you can better understand what it means to take a stand against one of the most biggest, one of the most common problems in society. Remember that standing out should always be embraced. Our uniqueness makes us who we are, and no one should make us feel bad about that. Rather than attacking a person for their differences, get to know them, make a friend. Do what's right, speak up and speak out, stop bullying.